Hello everyone, once again I welcome you all to the initiation on Learn From Home. And my dear students, today I have come up with the topic drainage pattern, right? So before I move into the concept of drainage pattern as a whole, first let me introduce to the word drainage separately and pattern separately, all right? Since drainage is separate from the word pattern, so let me first deal the words separately. So when we utter the word drainage, what comes in our mind? What comes in our mind? Drain. So if you find or if you search for the word drain in dictionary, what you will find? You will find to draw or to strain out the liquid or the water substances. All right, so what does the word drain means? To draw or to strain out, that means to remove away the liquid substances. All right, so now coming to the word drainage as a whole, generally what does it mean? It tends to explain the act or processes, or you can call it as a system, the system on which the liquid substances or the waters are removed from a particular place through a proper channel. So you come to know about the word drainage. Now coming to the word pattern. What does the pattern mean? Pattern means a geometric shape or the physical form which is visible to us. So now you have learned about the word drainage and pattern separately. Now I will be explaining the drainage term geographically. Now coming to the word drainage, and if I explain the word drainage geographically, so I can explain it in this way. That means drainage geographically means the flow of river. It tends to explain what? The flow of a river or stream. So how does a river flow? It flows in downhill manner, that is, it flows from the upper part and it flows downward, and at last it meets the sea and the ocean. So the major force behind the flowing of the sea from the upper part to the lower part is because of the force of gravity. So in a nutshell, what I can say is that drainage geographically tends to explain the system of a river. System explains how, why, and where the rivers are flowing. So while learning drainage, what you have come across? The word river system, or it may be regarded as the drainage system. So to explain river system or drainage system, what can be studied? The patterns where the river forms in its course, the patterns or the physical form. So the patterns or the physical form or the geometric shape are formed by what? By the rivers, the streams and lakes. And where is it formed? It is formed in a particular river basin. Now you have come to the word river basin. Now I will be explaining what is river basin. Now river basin or drainage basin refers to the area drained by river. Now this I will be explaining with the help of diagram, right? Suppose this is the glacier, or you can consider it as a hill or a mountain. From here a river starts its journey, and the starting point is regarded as the source. Alright, so this is regarded as the source or the place of origin of the river. And in its course, what happens? Several tributaries and distributaries joins the main river. So as the tributaries and distributaries joins the main river, what happens? The volume of the river expands. And as the volume of the river expands, what happens? There is more carrying away of the minerals or the materials from the upper part, and it is deposited to the ocean or sea. And hence it is regarded as the mouth of the river. And to regard the river basin, what I could say is that if you demark the area from the source and including its tributaries and distributaries, including mouth, it is regarded as the river basin. The demarked area including the river course is regarded as the river basin. And about the drainage pattern, what I could say is that a river in its course in a particular river basin forms a geometric shape or different shapes or a physical form which is regarded as the drainage pattern. Drainage pattern refers to the patterns or the geometric shape which are formed by a river in a particular river basin. So it is defined it in this manner. So now coming to the factors which governs different types of drainage patterns are, number one, topography or structure of land, number two, nature of rocks, three, slope of land, and number four, climatic condition. So topography or structure of land refers to how the landforms are aligned, whether the landforms are uniformly settled, whether there are irregularities composed of folds and faulted rock blocks, and second, nature of rocks. Nature of rocks means composition, whether the rocks are composed of hard materials or softer materials. Next, slope of land, that is the gradient, whether the slopes are steep or whether the slopes are gentle. And next is the climatic condition. Now, it is due to the four factors, several types of drainage patterns are being classified or categorized. Considering the factors, drainage pattern can be classified into three categories. So first is on the basis of dendritic pattern, which has been further classified into regular dendritic pattern and irregular dendritic pattern. And next is classified on the basis of trellis pattern. First is subdivided into trellis pattern and the other one is rectangular pattern. And the third one is on the basis of geometric shape. So first subdivision is radial pattern, centripetal pattern, annular pattern, parallel pattern, and last one is barbed pattern. Now I will come to this classification one by one. So please concentrate on it. Now coming to the first classification, that is the dendritic pattern. So in this context, I would like to draw the word dendritic, all right? So it has been derived from the Greek word dendron, meaning tree. So the dendritic pattern looks like tree, like it has the trunk, that is the main river, and it is joined by several tributaries as the tree branches. So hence, it has a tree-like structure and it is regarded as the dendritic pattern. Now the dendritic pattern has also been classified or subclassified into two. The first one is regular dendritic pattern. So the regular dendritic pattern are basically formed in the places which has uniform lithology. That means there are no irregularities formed. That means there is no prevalence of folded structure or faulted structure. The landforms are regular in nature. Uniformity or equality has been maintained. And next, dendritic pattern always follow the slope of land. It does not flow haphazardly. It always follow the slope of land. And next, it is mostly prevalent in humid climatic condition. Now here, I would like to say that humid climate condition is mostly characterized with what? With high amount of precipitation. So it is due to the high amount of precipitation what happens? The tributaries are majorly profound. That means, suppose this is the major river and from all the directions. It is due to the heavy precipitation, the tributaries are fed with the water. And hence, what happens? The tributaries are joined from all the direction. And thus, it forms a tree-like structure like this, and it is regarded as the regular dendritic pattern. And it is mostly profound in the river system or river basin of Ganges and Godavari River. Now, similarly, the irregular dendritic pattern are also similar to that of the regular dendritic pattern, but the only difference is that it has less tributaries. Suppose this is the main river, it is joined by smaller tributaries. Why? From or less tributaries. Why? Because it is mostly profound in the arid condition. Arid condition, or the places which experience less amount of rainfall. And hence, it is regarded as irregular dendritic pattern. And it is mostly profound in the Thar desert area of India. Now, coming to the second classification, that is based on trilice pattern. So, first sub classification is trilice pattern itself. Alright. So, the trilice pattern are basically characterized by right angles or 90 degree angles. So, how is it characterized by 90 degree angles? Because all the tributaries join the main river in the form of 90 degree angle. And next important thing is that it develops over the beds of hard and soft rocks. That means it is formed over the lithology which consists of harder and softer rocks. Such as, so here I'm drawing, suppose these are the rock beds. So with black I'm drawing hard rock, and with green I'm drawing soft rocks and again hard rock. So here you could see there are the parallel beds of hard and soft rock. By black I mean hard rock, and by green it means soft rock. Now here I would like to draw how the trilice pattern are formed. Suppose a river originates out here and it does not cut away the harder surface. It tends to bend down and it cuts away the soft rock, and again it does not cut away the hard rock, and it again tends to bend down and it cuts away the softer rocks, and it does not cut away the harder rocks. So this way a 90 degree angle has been formed by the main river or main stream. And next important thing is that four sequential streams are profound in the trilice pattern. So what are they? The consequent stream, the subsequent stream, the resequent stream and obsequent stream. So by consequent stream, what does it mean? It means the main river. It means the main river that follows the slope of the land. And second one is the subsequent stream. Subsequent stream refers to the tributaries that joins the main river. So suppose this is the tributaries, all right? And this is regarded as the subsequent. And another one is resequent. Resequent are the tributaries that are joined to the main river and are parallel to the main river. That means it forms a parallel tributary such as like this. And the next and last one is the obsequent. Obsequent are also regarded as the tributaries that joins the main river but in opposite direction. So all the rivers are flowing downward You could see the arrow, but in obsequent what happens, the river tends to flow in the opposite manner. So this way. So by this process, the trilice pattern are formed, where the stream cannot cross the hard rock beds, rather it crosses away the softer rock beds. As the rock beds are aligned in parallel manner, what happens? A right angle or 90 degree are being formed, and it is followed or substituted by what? Four major sequential streams, that is consequent, subsequent, resequent and obsequent. Consequent means the main river, subsequent means the tributaries which joins the main river, and resequent means the tributaries which joins the main river, but it joins parallel to the main river, and obsequent refers to the river which joins the main river but in opposite direction. Now the trilice pattern is divided or subdivided into another form, that is rectangular pattern. Rectangular pattern is also similar to that of the trilice pattern, but here the rectangular pattern are mostly profound in the structure or the rock types which are folded or faulted in nature. And in this folded or faulted landscape, what happens? There is the prevalence of hard rock blocks, which is cemented in nature, and it is due to the cementation, the streams does not cut away the rock blocks or the landscape. And here the tributaries joins the main river in 90 degree angle. So suppose this is the landscape or land features. So this is folded or faulted in nature. So here what happens? A river tends to flow in this manner, following the slope. It does not cut away the hard rock, but it tends to bend downward. And again, it follows the rock structure. It does not cut away. It follows the rock structure in this manner. And in this manner, the tributaries are also joined in right angle direction. So with this, what happens? The rectangular pattern are formed, and it is mostly profound in the Vindhyan range of India, and also it is found in Colorado Plateau. The geometric shape classification for drainage pattern incorporates first classification, that is radial or centrifugal pattern. So in radial or centrifugal pattern, what happens is that there is an upland in the middle, and from this upland the stream tends to radiate outwards in all directions. So the upland may be comprised of volcanoes, or it may be a hills, it may be mountains. So from this upland, what happens? The stream tends to radiate, and the best example is Amarkantak hills, from where Narmada and Son river tends to radiate. Another subtype for geometric shape or geometric dendritic pattern is centripetal. So it is opposite to that of the radial or centrifugal pattern. So in centrifugal pattern, what happened? There was the upland in middle, and from the upland the stream tends to radiate. But in centripetal pattern, what is prevalent? There is the lowland in the middle, and the streams from all the direction tends to come towards the lowland, and it is mostly prevalent in the Tibetan highlands and Bagmati river. Now moving on to the annular pattern. So annular pattern are found in the upland which has the outer soft materials, and it is because of the outer soft materials radial or circular patterns are formed by the river or stream. So suppose there is the upland in the middle, so what happens? The stream tends to develop over the softer materials. So hence the circular pattern is developed, and it piles
up, outwards, and in this type of annular pattern, the tributaries tends to join inwards in this manner. And the annular type of pattern is mostly profound in the other countries, but in India there are only few places or few river basins which has this annular type of pattern. So the examples may be cited of Prithoragarh in Uttarakhand and Nilgiri Hills. So only in these two river basins the annular type of pattern are being formed. So another type is parallel pattern or parallel drainage pattern. So parallel drainage pattern are profound in the region which has uniform slope, and the tributaries follows the consequent stream. That means, suppose this is the main stream for flowing in a uniform slope region. So what happens? The tributaries tends to join the tributary, the main river parallelly. So it tends to follow the path of the main river, and hence it is regarded as the parallel stream. So this type of parallel stream are basically found in the river basins where the rivers are swift in nature. And it is mostly profound in the lesser Himalayas and in the western parts of the India. So the last classification is termed or named as barbed drainage pattern. So the barbed drainage pattern, in this type of pattern what happens? There is the flow of the main stream. So the main stream is flowing according to the slope of land. But here what is the major significant factor is that tributaries joins the main river in discordant manner. Discordant manner means in the opposite manner. So if the river is flowing in this direction, the tributaries tends to join the river in this direction. And hence it is due to this nature, this type of pattern are seen as distorted form. And hence it is regarded as barbed drainage pattern. And it is profound in the Arun tributary, that is in the Kosi River found in Nepal country. So with this I have come with the conclusion of drainage pattern. And my dear students, this is not sufficient for you all. Please go through your text and please refer some other text and tutorial videos. Thank you.